And then there were 10. On Friday, August 23rd, 5G ultra-wideband service will be available in parts of Phoenix, Arizona, our 10th 5G city. Businesses and consumers in and around Phoenix will get to experience 5G speed and bandwidth and download movies, presentations, and large data files super fast. My friend Jenny is out in the Valley of the Sun. Jenny?
George, I wouldn't brave the heat for anything other than a very exciting announcement. We're here in downtown Phoenix at 3rd Street and Jefferson at the home of the Phoenix Suns. If you're in the neighborhood, come check out our 5G coverage at Phoenix Convention Center, Chase Field, and also at Arizona State University in Tempe. Why don't we try a speed test right now? Ready and go. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.5, 1.6. Wow, that's impressive.
Thanks, Jenny. Speaking of amazing speed tests, Marques Brownlee, one of the top tech YouTubers, debuted his 5G Explained video this week. He recently took a trip to Providence to check out how real 5G works. Link to his video is on the web. We're also announcing a deal with Boingo, you know, the people who keep you connected in public spaces, places like airports, stadiums, and arenas. We're working with them to bring 5G ultra wideband service to more places and indoors. Yay! You may have noticed Jenny was using the new Galaxy Note 10 Plus 5G. All three Note smartphones are available online and in stores tomorrow. We told you a couple weeks ago why this device is awesome in general, but there are some key features that business users will love. With Samsung DeX, you can put your mobile world on PC and Mac, while Link to Windows syncs all your files to your desktop. On top of that, Knox delivers next level security, and Bixby simplicity meets productivity with Bixby quick commands. And these smartphones are known for their cameras. Soon you'll be able to bring on-the-go video conferencing wherever you go. This year, Verizon is hosting the $1 Billion Roundtable, an event that recognizes corporations that achieve spending of at least $1 billion with diverse suppliers. You can catch part of that event during a live stream on Hans's Twitter feed today at 1 p.m. Eastern. Check that out, and until next time, you're up to speed.